the devil whispers, you cannot withstand the storm. In many ways, Ben-Hur, A Tale of the Christ, is the story of every person's struggle for life and meaning. And in a similar way, it is also America's story. Persecuted for their faith in God by a tyrant king, our founders escaped Europe to raise their families in faith and to advance the kingdom of God. Half of these brave pilgrims perished within a year of their journey, yet half lived to advance God's love and glory in a new world. They called it America. As a shining city on a hill, America became a destination for those seeking freedom. More arrived, and within decades, farms, towns, and colleges were flourishing. In the 18th century, after struggles and mistakes, a great spiritual awakening revived and strengthened the colonies. But with growing prosperity, their freedom was again threatened when King George of England became more demanding, stealing rights and property from the colonists. But patriots fought to keep their birthright of liberty. Through personal sacrifice, they won our independence in the great American experiment of the people, by the people, and for the people was born. The devil whispered, you cannot withstand the storm. But the patriot replied, I am the storm. Our Declaration of Independence held truths as self-evident, that all men are created equal and are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights. Among them, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. On this firm foundation of a loving God and ordered liberty, our Constitution established checks and balances to protect America against our fallen nature. George Washington became America's first president. He soon wrote, it is impossible to govern a nation without God and the Bible. John Adams made clear, our Constitution was made only for a moral and religious people. It is wholly inadequate to the government of any other. Grounded in faith and freedom, the young nation grew in strength, and America became an experiment in vitality. A new birth of marriage and children raised in Christian faith and hope. A new birth of innovation and exploration. A new birth of moral courage. Citizens standing for justice at home and defending oppressed people abroad. President Ronald Reagan warned that we are never more than one generation away from losing the precious gift of freedom our forefathers gave the world.
But only here did that little band of men so advanced beyond their time that the world has never seen their like since, evolve the idea that you and I have within ourselves the God-given rights and the ability to determine our own destiny. That freedom is never more than one generation away from extinction.
Today, many sense that our foundations are crumbling. Our moral compass is losing its true north. The enemies of America are both foreign and domestic. They use both violence and, more often, deception. They sow seeds of confusion within our institutions of faith, family, education, law, arts, and media. When the foundations are destroyed, what will the righteous do? The answer is found in the story of Ben-Hur and in the American story. Christ hands each of us a cup of water, which is the offer of his own life and strength. But we must grasp the offer as a person dying of thirst, and then give our lives back to the one who gives his life to us. It is also an offer to heal our nation When revived, we find our hearts, our courage. We find our purpose in the long fight for truth and goodness. You are now needed to help heal and revive our culture in every way. To restore the pillars of the family, law and government, the arts, media, science, healthcare, business, to grow the garden of our culture. When we work together, the pillars grow stronger, lifting the whole nation. Love leads. Any fully dedicated 2% of a population will change a society, whether for harm or for good. We choose the good. Millions grieve to see what's happening to our nation. But the prophet Isaiah said, those who mourn will later be called oaks of righteousness. They will receive a crown of beauty instead of ashes, and a garment of praise instead of despair. They will rebuild the ruined cities. They will restore hope and life to their land. We envision citizens in each pillar rising like mighty oaks before God and man. The devil whispers, you cannot stand. We are Americans. We do not surrender our liberty. We engage the battle. We pick up our swords. We drink the water of life. Because He is risen, we rise. We are Americans, and we stand. It's who we are. For our elders and the heritage they gave us. For our children and the future that is theirs. Join us for America. And join us at weserveusa.org. Together with you and partners like Wounded Warrior Corps, Task Force Dagger, and America Conservancy, we are the storm, and we stand for America's future because of love. Now enjoy Ben-Hur, the story of every free man and woman.